tell you what, it's God. Can somebody say amen?
Yes, amen.
Come on, somebody. Glory to the name of Jesus. Amen. I don't know about you, but I feel the Holy Ghost in this place. Amen. Ain't God good, somebody? Amen. Come on, ain't God good, somebody?
Yes.
Somebody give him a hand up there. Come on, brother. Give him a big God bless you.
Amen.
I can't, anybody come in here to receive tonight?
Yeah.
Every time I go to church, I come to receive something for God, not just to sit like a bump on the log, because I can do that at home. Can I get a hand in from a believer?
Amen.
You ought to come in every, with an expectancy. Hallelujah. Amen. Come on, put an expectancy upon the anointing. Glory to God. That God is going to move for you, that God's going to do something. Because God is a good God. Can I get an amen?
Yes, amen.
This is just a building, glory to God. Yes. God's moving you to another building, but you're the church. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory. Amen, amen. Last time I was here, I heard that little pastor talking about when he went to the doctor, went to the hospital. He didn't tell nobody. He just had his church praying for him. And I prayed. God gave me three different messages. And finally, pin me down, Lord. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory to the name of Jesus. Amen. And God wants to reiterate some things. God wants to lift you up. Can somebody say praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
If you got your Bibles with you, turn to me to John's Gospel.
Yes. Thank you.
We're going to get back to some beginning. Hallelujah.
Yeah,
I've only done this a couple times. I've been preaching for probably close to 20 years, and I've only went back to these scriptures right here two or three times, preaching, glory to God.
Yeah.
John chapter 3, we're going to start in 16. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
But I learned that in kindergarten. Hallelujah. Amen. We're going back to school. Can I get an amen from a believer?
Yes.
God loves you so much. Hallelujah. And I'm more than that, let me tell you something. God loves the person that's not saved. If there's somebody in here that's not saved by the blood of Jesus, you are the most important person in this house.
Yes.
Can somebody say amen?
Yes. Amen.
Those drunks and those no baptisms. Walking down the street out there, hallelujah. God's the one that died for them. Can somebody say amen? He didn't die for the church, he died for the sinner. Can somebody say hallelujah?
Yes.
I can't hardly contain it, brother.
Amen.
For God so loved the world. God so loved the world. Glory to the name of Jesus. Let me read this, because sometimes when I start this, I don't never even get to finish it. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believed in him shall not perish but have everlasting life. Here's the one right here. We love that. We know if we give our life to the Lord Jesus Christ, we know we're going to heaven. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
Yes,
I tell you what, your worst enemy, I don't care how much you hate him, don't deserve the devil's hell. Hallelujah. Because it's for eternity. It's from ever and ever and amen. But verse 17, for God sent not his Son into this world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
Come on, somebody. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I've heard people say, God don't go into the bars and God don't go into strip clubs. I'm here to tell you what. God does go into the bars. Hallelujah. Amen. I give my life to the Lord. And when I was around my mom and dad, I stayed saved because I was with them. I had an assurity. They talked to me about the Lord. They talked to me about Jesus. They talked to me about the anointing. They talked to me about the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. But when I was around them, they lifted me up, glory to God. But when I got away from them, I went back down to Georgia. I backslid. I went right back on God. Can somebody say amen? I went right back into those beer bars and those beer gardens. Hallelujah. And let me tell you something. Every time I took a drink, that God was convicting me. Don't tell me that God don't go into the bar after you.
Yes,
somebody say amen. God will go to the end of the earth to get you and to get anybody. Can somebody say praise the Lord?
Yes.
Glory to the name of Jesus. For God so loved, hallelujah, he loves you so much that God's not a condemning God. So we shouldn't preach a condemning gospel. Can somebody say praise the Lord?
Yes.
Whew, I've had people say to me, say, brother, every once in a while while you're preaching, you say something about people cussing and this, that, and the other. Because I'm telling you what, I've been around people that have been a whole room full of sinners and two or three Christians in there and be trying to talk to them about Jesus and trying to be a witness to them. And there be two or three of them in there saying, I'm saved by the blood of Jesus, cussing like sailors and telling dirty jokes. Brother, come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Amen. Yes, it upsets me. Hallelujah. Because we're in this thing. I'm in this thing with your pastor. Hallelujah. To see people saved, set free, healed, and delivered. Can somebody say amen?
Yes, amen.
You know, I'm backing him up. Glory to God. Amen. Praying for him every day. Backing him up. If somebody talks about your pastor, you ought to be ready. Hey, hallelujah.
Yes.
Don't talk about my pastor. Can somebody say amen?
Yes, amen.
Can't be like that, brother. Hey, the Bible said the kingdom of God shall revive and the Bible take it by force. Can somebody say amen?
Yes.
Sometimes you've got to tell some people some things, but do it in love, glory to God. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
Those people out there need Jesus. Whew. And they need somebody to stand up for righteousness.
Yes.
They need somebody to walk this thing out. They need somebody to clean their act up. They need somebody. When I look up to somebody, I don't preach to me a word. I want to see your life. Preach to me with your life.
Yes.
Can somebody say amen?
That's right, amen.
Talk's easy, but walk this baby out. That's what we got to do.
Right.
We got to walk the walk. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
It's easy to talk it. We can talk things all day long, but walking it, honey, that's another thing. I'm talking about fasting to take some things off. I'm talking about reading the Bible. The Bible said the engrafted word's able to save your soul. That's what cleans your mind up. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Can somebody say praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
Those people out there, everywhere out there needing Jesus. And in that place, all the drugs and stuff. I have a 25-year-old son, almost 2 years ago now, that OD had died. Hallelujah. We buried him. Glory to God. Come on, somebody. And I'm glad there were some people that would tell him about Jesus.
Yes.
I went to a church and preached this church, and the assistant pastor said, brother, I knew your son. And said, he told me that his dad was a preacher. And that's you. I said, yeah. And I got to tell him about Jesus. This is about 3 weeks before he passed away. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
I'm going to tell you something. God's a good God. Hallelujah. Amen. You might not be able to get through to your children. You may not be able to get through to your mom. You may not be able to get through to your dad or your grandparents or cousins or aunts, uncles or your neighbors or friends or whoever it is. But I'm telling you what, pray. God, send somebody along their path. Come on, somebody. Send somebody along their path to tell them about you. That somebody that can reach them. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
You can reach people that I can't reach. And I can reach people that you can't reach. Come on, somebody.
Yeah. Yes.
The things
right.
that you've been through. Come on, Jeremiah. I want you to go down to the potter's house. And I want you to show you something. Can somebody say praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
He's showing Jeremiah, look. I take an old vessel and make it anew. In other words, when you get saved, the things that you went through all your life, God don't throw it away. He still wraps it up.
Yeah.
Now it says, I used to be a drug addict. I used to be one of them people out there on the street. But I had a good job. I could afford my stuff. I didn't steal for it. But I did everything that they did. Come on, somebody.
Mm-hmm.
Everything. 25 years ago, I was out there doing the same thing. Hallelujah. And I thank God for somebody that showed me Jesus. They didn't just tell me. They showed me the love of the Lord Jesus Christ. Every time they see me, they showed me the love. And I knew it. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
I could feel the love. It wasn't just a talk. It was a walk, glory to God.
Amen.
I didn't know this was going to go this way. Hallelujah. Somebody needed to hear this. Whew. Churches ought to come together. Ought to come together with your pastor and pray and fast. God, send the people in. And not only that, it's not up to the pastor to go out and get them. Sheep be got sheep. It's up to you to go out and get them. Out into the highways and byways. Can somebody say praise the Lord?
Yes,
and compel them in, glory to God.
Mm-hmm.
We can talk, but let somebody see your life. The people around you, And here's something I tell people all the time. I am so proud of this. My kids, none of my kids, as old as they are, up to 27 years old, ain't none of them ever heard me say a cuss word, brother. Never. Why? Because it's not in me. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
I'm abundant of the heart, the mouth speaketh. Glory to the name of Jesus. Come on, somebody.
Yeah.
Well, hey, hallelujah. Hey, whatever's in you is going to come out sooner or later. Can somebody say amen? Come on, somebody.
Yes.
I don't get on nobody about cussing. I don't judge nobody about cussing. But I'm telling you what, it's a bad witness to those people out there. And those people out there need Jesus. Yes. Can somebody say hallelujah?
Hallelujah.
He didn't come to condemn the world, but through him that the world might be saved. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
Those people out there with the hair in the middle sticking up like this, purple hair, green hair, earrings that big around, no matter what they're wearing, hallelujah, amen. We need to go up to them. We need to show them the love of the Lord Jesus Christ. They need them. I'd love to come in and preach in a place where there's all kinds of hippies and junkies and sitting on the front row, hallelujah. Let me tell you something. Amen. As I was sold out to all that stuff, when I give my life to the Lord Jesus, I backslid, but when I come back, hallelujah, I was sold out to Jesus just like I used to be the devil's right-hand man. Now I want to be the God's right-hand man. Come on, somebody.
Yes.
God, give somebody glory.
Yes.
To the name of Jesus. Woo, hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory. God is so good.
Amen.
God is so good.
Right, amen.
Amen, amen. And look here, in verse 17 it says, for God sent not his son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Now here's where I want to go tonight. Saved in this passage in the Greek means delivered, protected, healed, preserved, and made whole. Healing is a part of your salvation. Being protected is a part of your salvation. Come on, somebody.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Amen.
1 Peter 2:24 said, by his stripes you were healed. Now you are healed, you were healed. If you're waiting on God to heal you, you're never going to be healed. You might as well make plans to go to the hospital. You're not going to get healed. Can somebody say amen? Because he already healed you. When you got saved, before you ever got sick, you was healed. Now you just got to reach out and grab it. That's who God is. That's the love of the Lord Jesus Christ. Come on, somebody. And we're redeemed from the curse of the law. The curse of the law was sickness and poverty, lack of want, and separation from God. The only thing that we really got down in 2020 is the separation from God thing. No matter what we do, we'll swear up and down we're going to heaven. Then we're saved. Can somebody say amen? We can act like heathens and I'm saved. Hallelujah. Amen. And I'm not getting on the church. I'm just trying to tell you something. No matter what we do, we'll say we're saved. How come no matter what, when we're sick, no matter what, we're healed? What's your name?
Sabrina.
It's not Mike. It's not Debbie. Can I talk you into being a Brent? Can't talk you into it. That's the way we need to be with healing.
Amen.
Can't talk you out of it.
Yeah.
I'm healed in the name of Jesus. But you know what happens? We'll get up here and we'll pray. Pastor will pray for you, lay hands on you, and God will move. Glory to God. And you're healed by the word, not by the way you feel. Oh, don't go by the way you feel. Because the devil, when you get prayed for, you'll be sicker than you ever was. The devil's going to work on you and try to take it from you. You don't have to talk God into nothing. Every perfect gift, hey, come on. Every perfect gift come down to the Father of love and the variable attorney or shattering. From the Father. Can somebody say amen?
Yes.
I got so much in me, I'm waiting to see which way he wants me to go. Hallelujah. Woo. Every good and perfect gift comes down from the Father.
Amen.
John 10:10 said, the thief cometh not before, but to kill, steal, and destroy. It's the devil that puts sickness on you. It's not God you have to talk into being healed. Oh, well, they heal me in the name of Jesus, and we'll quote scriptures, that's okay. When you get them in your spirit, amen. I've had people say, I read the whole Bible. So what? Big deal. How much of it do you believe?
That's right.
Come on. Thank God you read it all, but how much of it do you believe?
Yeah.
But you know, I believe it. Well, if you believe it, why are you still sick?
Come on.
Come on. Because it is God's will for us to be healed. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
I'm not getting on nobody. I'm not making fun of nobody. I got some problems in my body too. Hallelujah. Amen. I'm not just preaching to the choir. Can somebody say praise the Lord?
Glory to God.
Hallelujah. Jesus come to heal. He only saves you for two reasons. To save you, take you to heaven. To bless you, to heal you, and keep you safe and preserved and made whole. That's what he wants to do. He's your daddy. Come on, somebody.
That's right, amen.
He's your daddy. Mm. In the name of Jesus, he delegates his name to us. When we say in the name of Jesus, every demon got to leave. Every little imp of hell got to go. But brother, they come back. Say it again. Mm. Say it again. Say it again. Hallelujah. That's why when I get to church service and I see people sitting like a bump on a log, I think, my God, why? Why?
Yeah.
The people I see sitting, they must not have no troubles.
Yeah.
Must not have no troubles. Mm-hmm. Amen. Come on, somebody.
Yeah.
Your feet don't stink. Kool-Aid comes out of your faucet. Amen. Hallelujah. And your armpits never run. Amen. Your kids are sitting on the front row in church. None of them's on drugs. None of them's drinking. You got all the money in the world. Everything's fine, so you're not praising the Lord. I can't see nobody not praising the Lord. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
Come on. I'm not getting on you, but I'm telling you what. Hallelujah. The Bible said when the glory goes up, in other words, when we're praising God,
yes.
When the praises go up, when you're praising God, the glory comes down. That means your healing comes down. Oh, come on, somebody.
Yes.
When the praises go up, not when two or three people's praising, 40 people get, no. The ones that praising God, that's the one that's going to get a blessing. Can somebody say
amen?
Hallelujah. But if this one is just sing the song I like, nobody likes country music. I'm not a Motown wannabe or country has been, brother. Hallelujah. I love to listen to Jesus songs. I need healing. I need my kids set free. I need my kids saved. I need my kids delivered. That's why I praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I hope when somebody comes my kids' way and save them. I got kids living out there in left field that need saved by the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
Can somebody say amen.
Yes, amen.
Somebody tell them about the love of the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Woo. That's why I praise the Lord. I'm telling you why. Yeah, you should be shouting in here tonight. Your pastor said that God has given you a building. Glory to God.
Yes.
I pastored for 14 years trying to get a building. Couldn't even buy one. Whew. Couldn't get a praise team. Couldn't hardly get nobody to sing. That's why when somebody said, I don't want to go to that little church, it makes me so mad because I've been through it. I've been there when you've been a pastor and you're trying to raise this thing up and you're trying to praise the bills and you're trying to get people to sing so you can bless the people. I've been there. Can somebody say amen? Hallelujah. Now I'm here to tell you what. You need to hold hands with your pastor and his wife, hallelujah, and pray and fast, glory to God. Because let me tell you something, the devil going to try to take it away from you. But let me tell you something, I know people say, another devil. But let me tell you something, when it comes with another level, God equips you with it. Can somebody say amen?
Yes.
God's going to equip you with another bunch of angels to watch over you, hallelujah. The Holy Ghost is going to come down on you and put fire on you. Can somebody say amen?
Yes.
God's going to raise you up. God's not going to move you over there just for you to stay still, mate. Can somebody say hallelujah?
Yes, amen.
Ooh, glory to the name of Jesus. God is so good. God is so good. We need to come together in one mind and one accord, like the sister said. I'm telling you what, I'd get in tear bumps all over me when she was saying that. I tried to get, but like I said, I pastored for 14 years, tried to get people to come together, and you have these people over here and these people over here. And you got singers over here that think they're so good that they ought to be on TV and talking about these over here. I don't think it's good. I've been through it all. Can somebody say amen?
Yes.
And I don't know if I've seen it all, but I've seen enough. Can somebody shout
yes.
Glory to the name of Jesus. That's where the church ought to come together in one mind and one accord. Hallelujah. Don't worry about being a foot. Don't worry about being a head. Don't worry about being a mouthpiece or a leg. Hallelujah. The body's got to come together. Can somebody shout hallelujah?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Woo. Amen.
Boy, you got an opportunity. I think I was more enthused about it than y'all was when Pastor Kevin. I about ready to jump plumb out of my shoes over there. And I kept looking. Boy, they're sitting there like a bump on the wall. My gosh, man. Man. Hallelujah. Let me tell you something, women. In here, the Bible said the older teach the younger.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Don't just sit there. You need to be praising the Lord and show these kids.
Yeah.
This is the next generation. The ones back here, these are next generation prophets. These are next generation preachers. These are next generation teachers. If the Lord tarries, and can somebody say amen?
Amen.
We need to teach them what it is to praise the Lord. Brother,
right.
And I tell you what, I commend you tonight. Hallelujah. But I'm tell you what, the Holy Ghost jumped off him on somebody and you killed it. Because the Bible said the Holy Ghost jumps from breast to breast.
Yes, it does.
That's why I spoke up. I might have spoke up. I'll turn over the pastor. Didn't mean to. But I was wanting to see this place just go round and quiet.
Yes.
Right at night. And it would have if you would have submitted to that spirit. And when that spirit jumped off on you, hallelujah. But I didn't feel like I was supposed to. If you take the first step, God will help you take the second.
Yes. Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
I don't need somebody. Woo! God don't have to tell me to do that.
Mm-mm.
I get up and I start it. He'll be right with me. Doing
yes.
It. The Holy Ghost will be jumping with me.
Amen.
Can somebody say
yes.
Amen. Glory to the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Woo, glory. In Galatians 3:11 says, but no man is justified by the law, but in the sight of God is it evident, for the just shall live by faith. Hebrews 11:1, faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Amen. What I'm talking about tonight, I'm talking about faith. Your pastor said the other day he didn't tell everybody he wanted his congregation to pay for him. All right, let me tell you something. God sent me in here with the word tonight, amen, to raise you up, to strengthen your faith. Can I get an amen from a believer?
Amen.
Faith is a substance of things hoped for, everything not. You might not see it, and you're sure not going to feel it. But see, what you need is in another realm. And faith pulls it to you. Elijah, I'm Elisha. Elijah, I want to see what you, Elijah's sitting there and he's sitting there looking. Man, there's flaming chariots, there's angels fighting demons and devils. Man, he's just looking. There's a whole other world going on, fighting going on. He's just looking. And Elisha said, Elijah, I want to see what you see.
Yeah.
He said, it was God's will. And God opened up his spiritual eyes and he seen it.
Yes.
Can somebody say amen?
Yes, amen?
There's another realm out there. That's where your healing is, in that other realm. Faith is what jerks it out of that realm to you. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
Yes, amen.
All you do is have to believe. You got to believe God. Come on, somebody.
God, amen.
You got to believe God.
Yes.
God does the healing. You just got to believe it.
Right.
Faith's not saying, I'm healed. Faith is saying, I'm already healed.
Come on now.
And that's not lying to yourself. You tell the devil, it's the devil. Yeah, I got these symptoms. Yeah, I feel like yes. But I'm not going by what I feel. I'm not going by what I see. I'm not going by what the doctor says. Hallelujah. The doctor told me I had something the other day. Hallelujah. Amen. Was that, and I didn't forget a Virgo. Like I said, the doctor said I had. Did you hear what I said? Mm-hmm. Not have, had, past tense. Somebody asked me, what doctor? The doctor said I had, past tense. I have nothing. I have a healing going on.
That's right.
You got to watch what you say. It's like you, if you pray for your pastor, you're down here, you're praying for somebody. Oh, Lord, heal them in the name of Jesus, Lord. The doctor said they got cancer, Lord. Be healed in the name of Jesus. Amen. You get up and say, whew, they're healed. And your sister, your brother come to you and say, well, Sister Martha, what'd you pray for her for? She's got cancer. You just spoke it right back on her.
That's right.
Come on.
That's right.
Does anybody know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
What does Sister Martha got? Nothing. We pray for her. She's healed. We love one another, and we'll speak bad things on one another. But power, life, and death's in the tongue, folks. Hallelujah. Yes. Come on, even, you know, it just tickles me to death. And the devil's sitting there saying, come on, say it.
Yeah.
He's wanting you to get in doubt and unbelief. Come on, like Job. Job woke up every morning, amen, offered up sacrifices for his kids because they kept partying and drinking. And you know, and he said, the worst thing come on me, you know, the thing I've been thinking, the worst thing. He was only supposed to offer up this once a year. And he did it every day. He did it out of faith. And the devil seen it. Oh. And God said, did you consider my servant Job? And he's like, yeah. See, the devil knows the word. We got to live by the word. When you're not going by the word, he knows every little crack, every little corner, every little thing about the word. When you're not speaking the word about something, he goes to God. The Bible said he goes to and fro. He goes to God and says, look here. Now, Sister Mary right there, she's speaking doubt and unbelief, God. And God put his hands up. He can't do nothing. He's got to let Satan attack you. Why? Because you're not going by the word. But once you go by the word, he's, whoa. You leave her alone. Am I making any sense to anybody?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. You can't see your healing yet, but you've got to speak it. You've got to speak those things into existence. And when you're speaking faith, and see, when you're speaking your faith, it's mainly getting you to believe. It's on your end, not God's end. God's already done it. God is a God that speaks that goes all the way to the end of your life. He knows the end of your life and walks right back to where you at. But see, God sees you healed. He sees you set free. He sees you delivered. He sees you prosperous. He sees you, every good thing about you, he sees. It's up to us to grab a hold of it.
Yes.
We just got to believe God.
Yes.
His word, this holy black back Bible, this is God's word on paper right here. Glory to God. This is his brain right here. This is his thinking. This is everything he thinks. Come on, somebody.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Everything he thinks is right here.
Amen. Amen.
He said, I sent my word. And heals your disease. Does everybody get healed? No. Can everybody? Yes. Everybody can. Yes. But and I've heard people say, you know, why God took my little girl. God didn't take no little girl. God must need another angel. The Bible said there's 10,000 angels around the throne. He don't need another angel. Come on. The thief comes forward to kill, to steal, and destroy. The devil does that. Come on, somebody. Devil puts sickness on people. If somebody dies, the devil done it. And grant you, that is, hey, I'm 58 years old and getting older, and this body's fading because this body's cursed. Can somebody say amen?
Yes.
Amen. There's a lot of things this body does that the devil don't do to it, that it just does itself because it's getting old. It's wearing out. Can I get an amen from a believer?
Amen.
But there's a lot of things that the devil puts on us. Amen. But we just got to believe God and believe his word. Hallelujah. He's a good God. For God so loved the world. If God loved you when you was a sinner, God loved me when I was out there doing them drugs, and God loved me out there when I was doing all that drinking, and I was doing all that rowdy stuff, fighting and all that stuff. If God loved me then, how much more does God love you now that you're a child and a son of the living God? Come on, somebody.
Amen.
You're heirs and joint heirs to God. You're kings and priests under God. You're like a city set on a hill. Come on, somebody.
Yes,
hallelujah.
Amen.
That's who you are.
Try. Amen.
That's who you are. Next time you sing a song, you just think about how much God loves you. It's not just another song you're just throwing out there.
Oh, now.
Next time someone you have church service, lift up your hands and just don't worry about nobody besides you, your husband, your wife, your kids, and nobody besides you, nobody behind them, just you and God. And watch how God will move in your life.
Yes. God.
Hallelujah. Glory to the name of Jesus. Ain't God good?
Amen.
Yes. Let me read this last one right here. Hebrews 11 says, but without faith, it is impossible to please Him. Amen. Him being God. Without faith, you cannot please God. He that comes to God must believe that He is, and that He is a rewarder of those of Him who just seek Him. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Moses made his way up a mountain. He seen a fire up on a mountain. He made his way up on a mountain. Hallelujah. He climbed up that mountain. When he got up there, he seen a burning bush. And God told him, He said, this is holy ground. Take off your shoes. I mean, come on, somebody. That's where we ought to think of church. This is holy ground. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
Glory. Hallelujah. That's the way we ought to think in church. Amen. I mean, the building, when y'all come together, glory to God. But God told, and he seen the burning bush, and he said, God, I'm going to go down and talk to these people, but who do I say you are? He said, I am that I am. Hebrews 4:6, he said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. I know it's a salvation scripture, but let me tell you something. He said, I am the way. I am the way to your healing. I am the way to your prosperity. Come on, somebody. I am the way to your new church. Hallelujah.
Yes.
I am the way to your new sound system. Hallelujah. I am the way to the bank that's going to grow. Come on, somebody. Glory to the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. He is. I am. I am. The way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father but by me. Hallelujah. This is a real thing. This is a real thing. We come into church and we act like it's just another church service, like it's nothing. But I'm telling you what, our worst day is better than anybody's out there that's not saved. I mean, if you're sick, Satan's beating you down in your family, it's still a better day than it is for somebody out there. They're on their way to a devil's hell, and it's for eternity. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
It's for eternity, hallelujah. Let me ask you something. How big is your God tonight? How much do you rely upon Him? This man, this little boy, was outside washing the car, and his dad said, took his little boy and said, look up there, that airplane. Look how big that is. He said, Daddy, that thing's little. And he took his son a couple hours later and said, get in the car, son. I'm going to take you to the airport. I'm going to show you something. He went to the airport, and he pulled up there, and they got up to that fence, and that big old jet, one of them engines, was bigger than the car. He said, Daddy, that thing's big. How close are you to God? How big is your God?
Amen.
Come on, somebody. How close are you to God? How big is your God in your life?
Yeah.
Is the God real little? Hallelujah. Come on, I'm just hoping so and wishing that He does something. You don't get this by wishing, honey. You don't get it by hoping. You get it by faith, believing in Almighty God. Can somebody say
yes.
Amen? He saved you. He healed you all
right.
In the same day when you said, I do. Be my Savior. Healing come into you already. Hallelujah. Now all you got to do is believe it and grab a hold of it.
Yeah,
you don't
right.
have to talk
Amen.
Yourself into it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I tell people all the time, you know, I heard this one woman, she prayed for the same prayer every day. Every time she came to church, she prayed the same prayer about being healed. You know, God, the Holy Ghost spoke to me. She didn't believe she got healed last week. When you pray the same prayer over, you didn't believe you got it the last time, so you're praying it again. You prayed this time, you didn't get it last time, so you're praying it again. You're starting over. So by about this time, somebody religious is going to say, the Bible said pray without ceasing. Yeah, pray for him. Don't cease praying. Pray for her and pray for your pastor. Pray for your pastor wife. Hallelujah. Keep praying. Pray for the people out there. That's praying without ceasing. Can somebody
yes.
say amen? Come
yes,
on.
Yes, amen.
Pray for me when you ain't got nothing to pray about. Glory to God. Amen.
Amen.
God, I tell you what, pastor, don't ever take the preaching for granted. Don't never take it for granted. I did. In my last couple months there, I took it for granted. I did. I thought, boy, I'm tired. And I'm telling you what, I don't know what I can do to get to preaching more now. I took it for granted at one time. I'd love to be preaching every service somewhere. Glory to God. Amen. I repented of it. Kind of somebody say praise the Lord.
Amen.
God is so good. I want to see people saved. Hallelujah. I'm telling you what, nobody deserves to go to the devil's hell.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody.
Man.
Told God one time, yeah, if you don't think it's bad, I told God, I said, you know, hey, just turn your stove on, wait till it's red hot. I said, hold your hand there for about a year and a half. You couldn't do it for 3 seconds. That's what hell's going to be for eternity. That's what somebody's going to feel forever and ever and ever. Amen.
Yeah, amen.
Yes.
Because, see, when we go to heaven, we're going to get a glorified body. When people go to hell, they're going to get a glorified body. That way it can't burn up. They're going to feel that. Can somebody say amen?
Yes, amen.
I don't preach nobody into heaven. I don't preach nobody into hell. If God wanted me to, I'd be a hell fire and brimstone preacher if God wanted me to. I would do it. And I'm telling you what, even when I was a sinner, I knew I was doing wrong. I knew I was doing wrong.
Mm-hmm.
But thank God. The Bible said, let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Let the redeemed say what? That I'm delivered from the power of darkness. Let the redeemed say so. I'm delivered from the hands of Satan. I'm delivered from the sin nature.
Yeah.
See, when you're not saved, you got a sin nature. It's easy to steal. It's easy to do people wrong. It's easy. Flesh does it. But when you get saved by the blood of Jesus, I always used to tell people, you know, I got to clean this up. I got to do this. I got to do that before I go to church. But after I got saved, I finally realized when I got saved, somebody come inside of me and I wanted to clean up. You don't clean up and go to church. You go to church and God cleans you.
Yes.
Amen. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
It took me 2 weeks to quit cussing. Let me tell you something. I had a foul mouth around kids, women, I didn't care. And if the husbands didn't like it, I'd drag them outside. That's how I was. I didn't care. I'll tell you what, I'm perfect compared to what I was, brother. I might not be what I'm supposed to be, but thank God I'm not what I used to be. I mean, I'm not what I used to be. Can somebody say amen?
Yes.
Come on. Well, God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son.
Yes,
sometimes we got to get back to the beginning of things.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes we get so far up here, man, we forget about where we come from.
That's right.
Right.
Come on, somebody. We got to get back to the roots of this thing.
Right.
And we got to give the roots to somebody else. We got to pass these things on to people that need Jesus. Can somebody say amen?
Yes, amen.
I'll tell you what, hey, I knew some people that needed Jesus when they come visit my church. Look at them now. Huh? Look at them now.
Amen.
They might come in and somebody preach to them. Amen. Amen. Somebody plant a seed and somebody water. But one of these days, hey, the harvest is going to be ripe. They're going to come in and give their life to the Lord. We had a guy come in church. He sat in church for a year and a half. He come in every service. Every service. You know who he was.
Yeah.
Every service. And I'd call, and altar call, and I'd look over everything. And finally, about the last month, I called an altar call. I didn't worry about it no more. I started walking off that pulpit, and there he is, ready to give his life to the Lord. Don't ever give up on somebody. Come on, don't give up on somebody. You just keep praying. If they won't listen to you, my family won't listen to me. I guarantee you, your family won't listen to you. They might about some things. But I'll tell you what. You can pray and fast, God. If you want to save them, you pray and fast, and God will send people their way. Mm-hmm. Till somebody say amen.
Yes.
Amen. I was sick one time down in Georgia, and the two kids just running around the house. I was so sick, I didn't even know I was in this world. And my mom prayed, and somebody came over and knocked on the door. And they made their way in. His wife took the kids out to the car, and he was in his truck. He took me out of the truck and took me to the hospital. Don't tell me God can't move.
That's right.
Come on, somebody. When God sees your heart, He's seen the heart of this church. He's moving you to another building.
Yeah.
Plus, you're going to get to keep yours.
Yeah.
Huh? You're growing.
Yeah.
Not only going to have church and other people come to it. Amen. And putting together a praise team. Come on, somebody.
Yeah, amen.
You're going to have an outreach out here.
Oh, yes. Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm telling you what. This is the part I like more than all of them right here. All those people that need Jesus. Because the Bible said when one, just one, gives their life to the Lord.
Yeah.
Jesus said, shh. Uh-huh. Listen. They're coming home.
Amen. Right,
somebody
amen.
Say amen.
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 Yes.
If there's anybody in here tonight and you don't know Jesus, or you backslid, or I mean, you've heard what I've said. It's Bible. God loves you so much. He loves you so much.